Good afternoon, Alan Dare, the hero neighbour who was killed while trying to help police in rural Queensland last week, is this afternoon being farewelled by loved ones west of Brisbane. In a special tribute by the community, a convoy of classic cars has taken part in the procession behind his coffin on the way to the funeral, while members of the public gathered in a guard of honour to pay their respects. Queensland's Police Commissioner has confirmed Mr Dare will posthumously be given a bravery medal, which will be awarded to his family early next year. Christmas travel plans have been disrupted with thick fog at Melbourne Airport earlier today, forcing four international flights to divert to other cities. Other flights have also been delayed while waiting for the conditions to clear. It comes after heavy rain poured into the airport terminals yesterday, causing chaos on one of the busiest travel days of the year. On the other hand, it has been a smooth ride at Sydney Airport. These are the scenes this afternoon. Hundreds packing the domestic terminal, heading away for festive celebrations with their families. No sign of chaos. Passengers travelling trouble-free for now. And the final Christmas rush is in full swing. Shopping centres now swarming with customers. James Wilson braved the crowds at Sydney fish markets, where a seafood marathon is right now underway.
Well, the annual pilgrimage to the Sydney fish markets has well and truly begun. Right now, we're in the midst of a 36-hour marathon. What that basically means is that all of these stores around me will remain open until 5 p.m. tomorrow, as a predicted 100,000 customers come through the door and bag their catch.
When I arrived at just before 5 o'clock, the doors already open and people were filling up the shop, so it's lovely to see them back given what we've been through the previous 2 years with COVID.
Prawns remain the most popular item here. 120 tonnes are expected to be sold. That's 55 kilograms a minute. 70,000 dozen oysters will also be purchased. And for retail owners, this Christmas rush has taken months of planning and preparation.
For an event this size and the capacity of this event, we planned about 3 or 4 months in advance. That's the reason why we've got the variety that we have.
We all know that inflation has hit the grocery bills hard, but prices here are relatively on par with last year. You can pick up prawns from anywhere between $30 to $50 a kilogram. A rock lobster will set you back around $100 a kilogram. So the tip is to be patient, to shop around, and no doubt you'll put a smile on everyone's face come Christmas lunch.
For those hitting the road, a reminder, double demerits are now enforced across New South Wales, the ACT and Western Australia. They apply to a range of offences, including speeding, mobile phone use and not wearing a seatbelt. Former rugby league star Sam Burgess is denying allegations he drove with cocaine in his system. That's despite being arrested after allegedly failing a roadside drug test in Sydney, later charged with driving while suspended. The former premiership winner posted a statement on social media saying, "I am clean and sober from drugs." He'll be back in court early next year. To some developing news out of the US this afternoon, the committee examining the January 6 insurrection have released their final report. They've concluded that Donald Trump was the central cause of the attack, accusing him of a multi-part conspiracy to subvert democracy. The 18-month probe has involved 1,000 witnesses, 1 million documents and 10 public hearings. A boutique jewellery shop has been smashed up during a brazen theft in Melbourne's inner east. Gillian Lantouris has this exclusive report.
Well, this is all that's left of the Reflections jewellery shop front after it was targeted by thieves during an early morning robbery. Armed with a sledgehammer and a crowbar, four men try to smash their way into the Canterbury store but failed to get inside after a smoke cannon was triggered.
Just lowlifes.
But the fog didn't deter the men, instead smashing their way through the display windows, making off with around $50,000 worth of stock just before 3 o'clock.
I'm glad they didn't get in, but still, it's pretty hard this close to Christmas, having both my windows broken.
The devastated shop owner says this isn't the first time her store has been targeted. The same thing happened in June this year.
Pretty traumatic to go through it again. People are getting desperate.
Feel a bit unsafe about what's going on. You just don't know who they're going to target next time.
She's worked at the Mailing Road store for more than 20 years and says crime is at its peak.
It's just so tough. I work so hard to run this business, and after lockdowns, it's just work for what you should work and not just go and take it from someone else, especially a small business like me.
It's a really bad time of the year to be doing this to people. you know, so close to Christmas.
Investigators are now on the hunt for the four men who fled in a white Toyota sedan. Anyone with information is urged to contact police.
Nationals MP Andrew Gee is quitting the party effective immediately and will sit as an independent in federal parliament. Mr Gee, who represents the New South Wales seat of Clare, announced he's leaving over the party's decision to oppose the Indigenous voice in parliament. Nationals leader David Littleproud says his decision is unfortunate, but the party remains united in its opposition to the move. Gas producers say a federal government crackdown on gas prices is threatening up to 12 liquefied natural gas projects across the country. One of them, the Gina Rinehart-backed Senex project in southwest Queensland, has been paused. The government's upcoming code of conduct has prompted project bosses to review the $1 billion investment.
There has been no increase in the cost of production here in Australia, and yet there was massive, in some cases, a quadrupling of prices that were being offered.
As the fallout persists, the government's gas price cap has officially taken effect from today. Well, Christmas is almost here, and apart from the food and presents, there's always a vital component that needs to be taken into account, and that is the weather. To help us plan our days, we're joined by senior meteorologist Jonathan Howe. Jonathan, welcome. So put us out of our suspense. What's the weather looking like around the country for the big day?
Good afternoon, Kate. Well, just over a day to the big day, Christmas Day on Sunday. And from the Bureau, it's looking like good news for most Australians, especially across the southern capitals, looking like a gloriously warm and sunny day. So starting in Brisbane first, you might see a shower or two during the afternoon, but it won't be enough to kind of put off your celebrations, but just plan for any kind of wet weather that might come through the day. Go for tops of 28 or 29 degrees in Brisbane. In Sydney, we are expecting a little bit of cloud around the morning. We'll see some sunny breaks during the afternoon, and there is a slight chance of a shower or thunderstorms about the outer west. Maximum temperatures for you in Sydney of 28 or 29 degrees. In Canberra, we'll see some cloud in the morning, but warming up to a glorious day, top of 31. Very similar conditions in Melbourne, looking at a little bit of morning fog, but then a sunny afternoon. Maximum temperatures getting up into the high 20s, possibly even 30 degrees for some parts of Melbourne. And if you are in Darwin, it is the wet season, so we are expecting a few showers, top around 32 degrees. But for the most part, it is looking like a glorious day for millions of Australians.
Yeah, it's sounding good. Now, of course, weather curiosity doesn't just stop on the 25th of December. Boxing Day is also of interest. Should we be heading to the shops or to the beach?
I think you can do both if you really wanted to. Looking like a really lovely day again, especially for those heading to the cricket in Melbourne. It is looking like another warm day, top of 29 degrees. And then in Sydney for the start of the Sydney to Hobart race again, really warm conditions and strong northeasterly winds, which will really favour those yachts leaving during the day. Otherwise, looking at mostly dry conditions for the other capitals, except for Darwin with a shower or two. But yeah, looking like an absolutely beautiful Boxing Day. So really great pair of days. If you're heading out or staying home, something for everyone.
Well, Jonathan, if you could look into your weather crystal ball for me and maybe grant our New Year's Eve and New Year's Day wishes as well.
Yeah, so after Boxing Day, we are looking at a heat wave building across southern Australia, particularly South Australia, Victoria and Tasmania. So getting very hot in Melbourne, Adelaide and Hobart towards the middle of next week. We do see a cool change move through towards next weekend, of course, New Year's Eve celebration. So it is looking a little bit more on the mild side for the southeastern capitals, but mostly dry, apart from a little bit of cloud around Sydney Harbour and around Brisbane as well. So it is still about a week out. Just reminding people to keep an eye on those forecasts, no matter what your plans are for the Christmas and New Year's holiday, and to stay safe.
All right. Well, thanks for your time today, Jonathan. We're wishing you a happy and sunny Christmas where you are.